Good morning, guys. Thank you for tuning in. This is Fred here. Welcome to the channel. Today, I would like to elaborate more on water when it comes to dairy farming. Water properties, advantage, and key tips when you are feeding your cow water. So, watch till the end. Do not skip. Yeah, just watch till the end so that you can learn more about cow feeding. And we always say the most important food or feed when it comes to dairy farming is water. So stick to the end and so that you can learn so much about water and get insights that you didn't know about feeding the cow. So watch till the end.
Water is a critical nutrient for dairy cattle, and it is required for numerous essential psychological functions. The total body weight of a dairy cow is 56 to 81% of water, and the water is a main component of milk and waste products. Therefore, dairy cows or dairy cattle have a substantial daily requirement for water. The more water your cow drinks, the more they will milk. So there is a study that has been done that shows half of the dairy farms have poor quality water. This is because of irregular cleaning, because of bad system where low connecting pipes get dirt. In some cases, farms were found to have high level bacteria, iron, manganese, etc. The solution is simple: clean the troughs every day and put in back fresh, clean water as a routine. You can use brass to clean properly because of the stream nymphs that grow bacteria. The greening matter that you see on the water troughs, whether you're using plastic containers, bathtubs, you have to clean the green matter that you see there, that to ensure water intake to the cow. The cleaning time is paid back in milk production. So water is the first feed for your cow. We keep on saying that you feed 70% forage, 30% concentrated, but most people forget about water. Water plays the major part when it comes to feeding your cow. Your cow can go for a day without fodder, but it can't go for a day without having water. Yeah, and you must observe about the chlorine. Most of farms use tap water, and tap water contains chlorine. So chlorine is a powerful oxidizing agent, and the most common use disinfectant because it is inexpensive and effective at low concentration. In addition, if applied in a sufficient dose, chlorine has a residue effect. Therefore, chlorine remains in water and can continue to destroy the bacteria. So you have to be very keen when you are feeding water that has chlorine. Let it stay like for 24 hours, and then you feed it to your cow. So you should ask yourself, are your cows drinking enough water? So look at the cow coat. Are they shiny? Do they have smooth coat? These are signs of good water intake. Elastic skin is a good sign. You lift the piece of skin from the side of cow neck, it should pop back in a place within half second. If the wrinkle stays there after releasing, it is a sign of dehydration. So you should give it clean fresh water, yeah, so that you can fight the dehydration. What are the eyes telling you? So are the eyes of your cow live free and now big eyes? Are good signs, yeah. So you can test using even eyes. Just look at your cow. Does it have lively eyes? No, it has good water intake. If heifers and cow have very stiff manure, Then, likely, they are not enough drinkers. Perhaps one big mama or one big dairy cow there is ruling the place. You have to spend hours in front of the drinkers to show everybody that she is the boss, and other cows do not get enough chance to drink. The best half will be okay, but the weakest 50% are suffering. So you have to use open drinkers or containers is advised. So many people are using different method of feeding cow water, but I would advocate for open trough drinkers so that each and every cow will feel comfortable, will feel safe, and will have time to drink its water. So how do cow behave at the drinker? You should ask yourself that question. Are they scared of other cows or stray voltage? Are they looking around before drinking? Know there is a problem. Are they sniffing and not drinking? Know that water may be contaminated or is not safe for drinking. Are they passing the first drinker and walking to the next one? All these are the questions that you should ask yourself as a dairy farmer. Are they sticking their tongue in first to check the water temperature? Yeah? What is the temperature of the water? Do you hear them making sucking noises? This means there is not enough water pressure at the drinker for those who are using bowls. They are too small. Can the cow reach the water? Or in the rim is too high? So wide passages of and drinking, that is 60 centimeters, that is 24 inches high, are advised. If they are over 3 feet tall, cow can find it difficult, especially heifers. Heifers, they are not fully grown. So they are not so much tall compared to other adult cows. It is like drinking while you push a throat. So it is not good feeling and it makes the cow drinks less. So you must be very keen on that. So someone may ask, how many liters of water do they need? One thing that you should know is cow drinks like 10 to 15 times a day for half a minute. And it can go around 10 liters each time. So in hot weather, a high yielding cow can drink up to 200 liters per day. Yeah, it's not they can drink because it is hot. You know, water also assists the cow it regulates the cow temperature. Yeah, it has so many uses. Water, we have said water 56 to 85% of the cow body is water. Yeah, remember the same water is the one that you are using to flush out waste. The same water is the one that is using that is being used, yeah, to produce more milk. Yeah, so you have to be very, very keen. So the normal drinking speed of a cow is about 20 liters per minute. The more drinkers you put in, the better chances that your heifer will drink enough water. Cows like to have water depth at least 7 centimeters. They have to drink their mouth in without sucking the air at the side of their ribs. So for fast drinkers, you need water to flow for 20 liters per minute. So test drinkers with a big bucket. Do the drinkers supply 20 liters per minute? Are they easy to clean? Do they have nice round edges so that there is no risk of wounding the cow? Or are they wide enough so that the cow can start straight and drink comfortably? So these are the questions that you should ask yourself. Another thing that you should consider when it comes to dairy water is water temperature. What I would advise you is don't worry about the temperature as long as it stays above zero. But anything that is negative zero, you have to warm it. Yeah. So first, make sure that you have a clean water. Second, make sure that you have enough drinkers. And thirdly, check the pressure that they are always full. If the three major things are assured, now you can start to worry about the ideal temperature. Yeah. Around 17 degrees Celsius, that is 63 degrees Fahrenheit. cow drinks more in winter time when they supply, you supply warm water. So I advise a farmer to warm, that is lukewarm water, yeah, so that the cow can drink water. So if cow doesn't drink water, no, there are things that we have talked about, the milk will not be as much as it used to be. The skin of the cow will look, it will be hard, yeah. The eyes, all these are the signs that will tell you if the cow is drinking or not. Water from the milk cooler can be used for the cows, and a lot of people do this. Just beware, if you do not clean the drinkers, cow will drink less in the summer because of rapid bacterial growth. So warm water in the winter is okay. In the summer, it is risky. So for cooling the cow in heat stress, we prefer cold water, and that is being used. So you can have manure in the drinkers. The position of drinkers is very critical. If you have narrow passage, use a fast drinker in every passage. So cow always like to drink when they come and go from the feeding alley. So a passage without a drinker is not a good idea. Yeah. And the place that you set your feeding, your water trap is very, very crucial. Yeah. So you have to take note on that. Now, there is another thing that water immediately after calving. So after calving, unlimited lukewarm water is suggested to like 20 liters, and then you have to mix it with like sugar. Yeah. So it is suggested to get the cow back in shape and to get her eating as soon as possible. Some cows will drink like 100 liters in the first hour post calving. There are advantages of adding glucose and electrolyte to stimulate water in the feed intake. Yeah. And for those who feed milk replacers, they can be mixed with what? With warm water. So all these are, you can mix it with warm water and to feed to fresh cows as a means of achieving these well, providing calcium at critical time. So what we are seeing is water is very, very crucial when it comes to dairy farming. You must invest in water, invest in good and clean water. Yeah. Then we have waters as pastures. Cow shouldn't have to walk further than 500 feet to water at pasture. Ideally, this should not be from a stream or pond, as this can pose both animal and environmental problem. So if you are not doing zero grazing, you are doing free range, make sure the point at the water point are near. Yeah. However, water consumption may be decreased if the poor quality of water is offered. Decreasing free water intake is undesirable, and it will limit milk production and reduce health status, resulting in decreased producer profitability. So water is equals profit. The more water your cow, the more quality water your cow drinks, you will see that in milk production, in the health of the cow. Yeah. And reduce as much as possible. We have different types of stress of cow, and water is one of the stress. So always check on that. Make sure that your cow is drinking. Yeah. Take around 15 to 20. Watch how your cow behaves. Yeah. You can install CCTV in your cow shed so that you can see exactly what happens when you are not around. Yeah. Then, how do you measure the water quality? These are a bit scientific, but it's also good to say. How do you know the water quality, or how do you? Which criteria do they use? One, we have total dissolved solid, that is TDS, or total soluble salt, TSS, and salinity. Total dissolved solid or total soluble salt, as like now we can say physicochemical properties of water used to assess water quality. The term is used in non-mastery and measure the amount of sodium chloride, bicarbonate, sulfate, all those micronutrients that are in water. Now, when we talk about choline, so many people are using tap water, yeah? And we said choline is an oxidizing agent, yeah? And it affects, yeah? It affects or destroys bacteria in the rumen. So you have to be very, very keen, as we said, about the choline. Another big criteria that can use is hardness. Hardness of the water. It's generally a measure of calcium, magnesium, iron in water. Zinc, iron, aluminium, manganese can also contribute to water hardness. However, they are generally present in no concentration. But if they are high in, they are very high, have high concentration, that the water will be hard. So you have to be very keen on that. Another thing is nitrates. So nitrate, drinking water, especially from surface or shallow ground, may become contaminated with high level of nitrates. Sources of nitrate in water include fertilizers, animal waste, fecal materials, crop residue, or industrial waste. So nitrate poisoning results from bacteria reduction of nitrate to nitrate in the rumen, with the nitrate being absorbed into the blood and reducing oxygen capacity, carrying capacity. So you have to be very, very keen when it comes to that. So watch about animal waste. Is your water coming out from or around the animal waste, yeah, the industrial waste? So you have to be very keen on that. Another thing that you can know the criteria of water is by having something called sulfate. Calcium, iron, magnesium, we have sodium salt, a most common form of sulfate found in water. While hydrogen sulfate is the most toxic form, high concentration of sulfate, especially sodium sulfate, produce a laxative effect in cow. However, normally within a week, cattle becomes acclimated to the water and diarrhea is no longer apparent. Another thing that you can know is about iron and manganese. Neither iron or manganese in water present health hazard to the dairy cow. However, the presence of these minerals may cause taste and the problem along with accumulation of the pipe reducing water flow. So you have to check all those things that we have said, guys. So water is very crucial. Yeah, and remember, when the cow is fed on dry matter, the more intake, the more water it will take. So it is, you have to decide, yeah, decide and come up with a good plan of water, yeah, when it comes to your cow. So you can invest in tanks. You can invest in tank if you have a problem. You have a problem in your area, and I always advise farmers, when it is raining, take advantage of the rain, harvest as much water as possible, yeah? So it is economical, because if you are being supplied water, you'll not be paying. Water from rain water is free, yeah? All you need is you invest in tanks, in storage, and you'll be good to go, yeah? So water is life, and I always tell guys that water is everything. Water is the first food for the cow. So I hope you learned something, and if this channel is of value to you, please subscribe, comment, share, and let's add this grow channel too, so that we can reach as many farmers as possible. So thank you for your time, and have a wonderful time.